Well, good evening, everybody. So glad to see you out here on a rainy night with Shady Grove for our program. And these guys have been chomping at the bit for the past 2 hours, and those guys over there with the sticks, probably even longer by the age of them. We are so glad you're here. A little bit of housekeeping. If you need to use the restroom, please go out that door, all the way in the back, and all the way to the right. And we will have a children's play first tonight, and then we'll have an adult play. And we're so glad you're here. But let's start out with prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, I am so thankful for this crowd. More than that, I am thankful for your presence, the presence of the Holy Spirit. Lord, I'm thankful for all these young folks who have come just trying to share your glory with everyone. I just pray, dear Lord, that you'll settle their nerves. And dear Lord, that you will help everyone to receive the message you have for the season, which is of our Savior. And dear Lord, most of all, I thank you for sending your Son, Jesus Christ's holy precious name. Amen.
All right, good evening. We're going to finish up our Advent candle tonight, and we will do that now. 4 Sundays ago, we lit the prophecy candle and remembered those who spoke the promise of the coming Christ child. 3 Sundays ago, we lit the Bethlehem candle, a symbol of the preparations being made to receive the cradle, the Christ child. 2 Sundays ago, we lit the shepherd's candle, remembering the first in a long line of people who joyfully shared the good news of the Savior's birth. And last Sunday, we lit the angel's candle and were reminded of the hope fulfilled in the first coming of our Savior and our continuing hope as we anticipate His coming again. Tonight, the Advent season ends. We no longer wait. The great event of which we've waited has happened. God's promise of a Redeemer is fulfilled. Christ Jesus is born. We light the Christ candle with praise to our God who brings joy to the world. Our reading comes from Isaiah chapter 9 and verse 2. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land, the shadow of death upon them hath the light shined. Thou hast multiplied the nation and not increased the joy. The joy before thee according to the joy in harvest. And as men rejoice when they divide the spoil. For thou hast broken the yoke of his burden, and the staff of his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, as in the day of Midian. For every battle of the warrior is with confused noise. The garments rolled in blood, but this shall be the burning and the fuel of fire. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace shall there be no end upon the throne of David, and upon his kingdom to order it, and to establish it with judgment, and with judgment from the henceforth ever forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Let's pray. Father, we thank you so much for this day. We thank you for the promise and the fulfillment of your Son. And Father, tonight as we remember that, honor that, and are in awe of that, we know that because you so love the world, you gave us your Son, that whosoever should believe in him should not perish, but by your grace have everlasting life. Father, help us tonight as we go into our plays. Help us as we go into these times, Lord, as we remember this Advent season. Father, bless each heart and mind that is gathered here. For it's in your holy and precious name I ask these things. Amen.
All right, I'm going to ask
to start our children's play this evening. You see nothing. In Genesis chapter 1, in the beginning, God created everything. Then he created man and woman. Everything went fine for a time, and then it happened. The devil told Eve if she ate from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, she too would be as smart as God. And God told Adam not to eat from that tree, and he told Eve that there was only one rule to obey. But she pulled the fruit and ate it, and so did Adam. That's when sin entered the world, and that's why we were all born with a nature to do wrong things. And way back then, God had a plan. That plan would happen many years from that day. Day by day, God waited until the right minute, and it happened. An angel appeared to a young lady named Mary, and Mary was probably very frightened. But Mary kept all these words in her heart and gave much thought to them. Say to a young lady who was engaged to be married, to her soon-to-be husband Joseph, what have I done? What will Joseph say? What will everyone say? That very night, Joseph slept softly. Well, not softly, because he snored very loud. Joseph woke up from his dream, shaking his head. How could it be? How? Us? Why? For an angel had come to him too in a dream. The king sent a letter to everyone to the villagers. He said, you go to the city of your birthplace and pay your taxes. By this time, Mary was about to give birth to this baby. But the law was the law, and it didn't wait for any baby. They started their journey on a donkey with their bags and with no hotel reservations because they didn't have a cell phone to call ahead. Hoping for an empty room somewhere, Joseph started knocking on doors. Each time the same, sorry, no rooms left, no rooms left. Joseph knew before they said it, no rooms. Joseph was not taking no for an answer this time. But no was the answer. But my wife, he said. The door slammed anyway.
Thank you.
scene one. Okay, we need our major scene folks up there. Folks off. Now we need the wise men on stage.
Shady,
Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem, Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him."
Besides, it'll take us a year or two before we get there. Follow this star to the one that has been told. It will take us so long.
Join the cast in singing "Away in a Manger." Everyone ready? Couple minutes, we'll switch gears to the